We've gone really quite a long way here today about what's going on and try and examine how it happens and what could happen. Starting in 1927, when I started doing what I'm doing, coming out of a building world and going back and taking up my general systems theory, which I learned in Navy and how you play war games of Navy, I said, I think Navy is a comprehensive anticipatory design science product. Everything that had to be designed. Some of it took 25 years, all the blast furnace survey. Now, I think this kind of a capability, if it were really, it didn't have the working assumption that Malthus had right, it had the working assumption that you could doing more with less, you might be able to take care of everybody. If I took general systems theory and applied, I might be able to apply it to how to make the world work instead of how do you make one side survive. So I started playing that in 1927. I call it World Game. Now, World Game I've used right along. I wouldn't be able to talk to you if I have. I've been really operating this and trying to find out what the mathematics of it are, may be, and how to find all the complementarities and how to integrate and use synergy. But I've now come with a computer available, and the computer becoming then this great antibody to save man. I find man has enormous confidence in the computer, whereas no politician could ever yield to another politician without being traded inside. Any politician can yield the computer without losing any face at all. So we have to have a way in which man can yield without losing face. And I find the computer can put the problem in there, which way do both sides profit the most? And that's exactly what you can do. So I've been developing a world inventory, world resources, human trends and needs, I call it. My Southern Illinois University has been backing me this for very many years. And now we're about to undertake a Southern Illinois University the $16 million program with the computer, and we're playing this world game. And we're simulating that play, and I find in every kind of a way, I've got four or five assimilated plays actually carried through longhand, and we find, yes, we can make the world work in a dozen different ways, many options. But the world game is going to be so photogenic with a really great world map that it becomes highly desirable for the great television and moving picture companies to just take pictures. Every magazine's got to take pictures. And it can continually confront society with their options that they have other than the political. They won't agree at all with any of the political theories. And society, as it gets more and more predicament, which it's going to say, well, that computers keep coming out there. Why don't we play that computer world game way? So I see this may be the way in which we will possibly emerge in a great hurry.